Boy, welcome you to Jackie Robinson Stadium. We're getting ready for kickoff in this LCFL contest between the Blackhawks and the Eagles. And with us here is a man who spent more days in Vancouver than me, and I am absolutely envious of it, but he has good reason why. That's DJ Carter right here. And you spent some time up there with EA Sports, which is pretty exciting. So describe what you're doing there.
We were working on a new Madden 2017 video game, doing stunts, diving, making it more realistic for the kids, doing routes and all that stuff.
And so you were standing on a green screen, you had the dots all over your body.
All the dots all over your body. Yeah. The hot suits and everything.
Right,
8 hours a day.
If it's anything like acting, what was it? Was it strenuous? Was it tedious? Was it exciting? Was it different?
Well, the trick is that they don't want us to show our full athletic ability because, again, it's for the kids. So we had to, like, tone it down a notch.
Oh, wow. Yeah, okay.
Couldn't come out to break as far as we do out here and stuff. We had to tone it down. It's more acting.
Now, how did you find out about this opportunity?
Well, I train at USC every offseason, and the guy, Mazio Royster, that's the coordinator, yeah, he was up there because he's a USC alumni. He was chilling, and he just gave me the opportunity and went from there.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
What did you like most about it? That seems to be pretty
about
awesome.
About the Madden game?
Yeah.
Man, just growing up as a kid, you never thought that you'd get an opportunity to make the game.
Right.
Help make the game, so it was cool.
Today's game, now we took a look. Actually, Kyle Parrish posted it not long ago how evenly distributed the stats are as far as passing to the wide receivers. And you've had a remarkable first year with the team. So, what's been the most important thing for you coming to the Blackhawks?
First, being a team player, because we have a lot of good receivers and everything. So, just having patience, being a team player, and then contributing on special teams. Yeah, that's big.
What's the key? Now we might expect we kind of expect a win here tonight.
Right.
But what do you expect to do for yourself? What are you looking to get out of today's game?
I just want to play my role, right? Whether it's taking away the corner of the safety so the run game can come through, or the seams or the slots. I just want to play my role, right?
Well, we appreciate
yes,
the time,
sir.
And thanks a lot.
All right.
Thank you. There he is, DJ Carter. We'll be back with more in a moment.
Thank you, John. Thank you. Tyler.
Back here in Los Angeles, the Blackhawks have 3 games left on the regular year, and it's going to be pretty beneficial for the Blackhawks because it will be 1 game on, 1 game off, 1 game on, blah, blah, blah. Here with us, before we get the game started, is Nelson Maldonado, lineman for the Blackhawks, and big game last week, 76-0 final score. This week could be a similar result, but we had seen the Eagles before and did quite well back in the second game of the year in league play. So having seen them before, are there any adjustments the team might need to make for tonight?
As far as adjustments, I don't think we need to make any adjustments. I mean, ever since week two, our whole team came out stronger than ever. You know, like we've been sticking together now. So our chemistry's there, our fundamentals are there. So right now we're just letting, pretty much playing all-out football, and smash-out football, and just do what we do best.
Now, we mentioned it earlier, 3 games over the next 5 weeks are going to be very beneficial. You're going to be fresh every game. Is there any reason to pace yourself tonight or just go all out?
Like I said before, just play Blackhawk football when we do best. Just play all out and just do what we do best. Just put up all these numbers on everybody.
What's been your most enjoyable experience being a Blackhawk?
It was my first season as a Blackhawk, so overall, what I like best is just a family. You know, everyone's right here, brother. So every single player here has my back. So I really feel comfortable with that.
We love the sound of that. We get you in good job. That's how we do it. There he is. Appreciate your time. There he is, Nelson Maldonado. We'll be back with more in a moment. Here at Jackie Robinson Stadium. Stop it. I love the off-camera stuff. Especially when Tasha does the video bomb. Just walk behind the shot. I love that stuff. But we're here with Edward Flores and defensive lineman, and he's had an excellent year. I mean, always crashing in on the line. And what's been the big thing for the defense this year, maybe in comparison with others?
It's just, you know, new players that we acquired last year, this year we build a better bond. You know, we know who's going to be and what in which assignment. And as a line, you know, we're pretty much solid all the way across, you know, with the starting with our defensive ends, with Marcus Kelly.
Yeah.
Dwight Hamilton and Django too.
Yep.
And
he's been a lot of fun.
Moore, June, we're all putting in work.
Yeah.
So it's working out. And Allen's having a heck of a year as well.
Right.
So,
Brian Allen's had a big year for him.
Yeah.
But
it's been a big year, and everyone's getting their stats. I mean, it's been wonderful. Everyone's been getting their reps. That's the most important thing, yeah. not just the stats.
Yeah, Tim's doing an excellent job with our rotation, keeping it fresh, and, subbing it in, putting special packages in, our blitzes as well, doing a lot of D-line blitzes. Well, stunts, what you would call it,
Right.
Throws the offensive lineman off guard, and sometimes you mix them, with cornerbacks or safeties. Right.
And you'd see, we saw the Eagles in week two. Anything different that you saw then that you might want to adjust for tonight?
Nah, just all gas, no breaks. That's pretty much it,
Love it. Yeah.
Smash my football, that's what I like to do. I love contact.
Right.
That's me. I love,
I know you do.
Making the big hit
Well, players definitely feed off of it. It gets them in his zone, gets some focus.
Yeah, exactly. I like to throw the trash talk in there as well, Barbecues in the backfield. I don't know if you hear me up there.
I've heard.
Yeah, man. that gets my guys going, I feed off of them,
Right.
Feed off of me, so we love it.
Now, lastly, can I do the sprinkler thing?
Yeah, let's do it together.
Okay, here we go. Ready?
We're going to
to left. Okay.
Yeah, and then make sure you get the break.
Okay. All right, let's do it.
Let's go.
There it is.
That's awesome.
Henry Flores there. Appreciate your time. Good luck.
Yeah.
There he goes. Henry Flores. Walking through our shot. That's how we do it. We'll be back with the kickoff coming up in a moment. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Jackie Robinson Stadium in Los Angeles. It is great to be back home. We present to you LCFL West Football as today the SoCal Eagles take on the Inglewood Blackhawks. Hi, hello, how's it going? My name is John Tyler. It is great to have you with us for this one. The Blackhawks entered today's game at a record of 7-1 in league, 11-1 overall. The Eagles, they have struggled. In their past three games, they've only scored 10 points. In the last matchup, in the second game of league play, the Blackhawks played in Chino and defeated the Eagles by a score of 64-12. We even had a lineman score a touchdown, which was actually pretty phenomenal from 6 yards out. We spoke with the players earlier. Not much should change as far as a final score is concerned, but one of the bigger concerns here today is, of course, keeping the players healthy, getting them their reps, keeping everyone happy. I know it's easier said than done, but get out of here with a good result and move on to a road game on the 25th. That's right, a Sunday at the SoCal Coyotes. This should be a good game, and the Blackhawks should be on their way to a 12-1, 8-1 mark, and should be a wonderful game. Stick and stay, we'll have a whole lot more, including the kickoff, in just a moment.
All right, here we are in Inglewood. We're about to get the kickoff going here, the Eagles and the Blackhawks. I'm Jay Tando. I'm joined here. John Tyler will be doing our play-by-play.
Hey, it's great to have you with us, and happy to have you along for the ride, Jay. Appreciate your assistance here tonight. Getting ready for the kickoff. It's Dakota Ramsey to put a boot into it. And week 7 is underway. And the kickoff is returned from the 22-yard line. And it's a return of 12 yards to the 24. First and 10 for the Blackhawks. They're running the clock already. How about that? I think they know the impending doom, Jay.
14:50 and ticking. Tick, tick.
Yeah. Wow. How about that? It's Cal Parrish at quarterback. This is Wayne Chapman. Had an excellent year. No, it's... In fact, on the handoff, it's Kendall Gordon who gets the assignment. He told me he's 25, so that's the way it is. He gets about 6 up to the 41. No huddle here of the SoCal defense. And because of that, we have confusion. And
so it looks like we're at the 44-yard line with 14:19 to play in the first quarter. No score.
Carry of 12 for Gordon, who's getting the assignment tonight. He gets it again. He bounces to the left. Doesn't he look like Brian Flowers? He is up the middle and to the 30, the 20, 15, 10. Goodbye. That is a 56-yard touchdown.
Comes the extra point. 6-0 is our score. Blackhawks on top. Just started 14:08 to play in the opening quarter.
And with no Ryan Hunt on board tonight, they will be going for two all night long. So that's what they're doing in the spread. It'll be trips to the left when they snap. Parrish to throw. He does not go. Oh, he blows a tire. And the throw goes incomplete.
as it is a 56-yard run for Gordon.
All right, here we go. Kickoff. It is 6-0 with 14:08 to play in the opening quarter. The Blackhawks on top of the visiting Eagles.
Mike Johnson to put it into play. Hey, decent. Look at that. End over end, and the return is from the 11. That's Gage, the wide receiver. He moves it up to the 25-yard line. Favorable field position. Give it up.
From the 25-yard line, the Eagles will take over. 14:01 to play in the opening quarter here. 6-0 is our score. Inglewood on top.
Sean McKinney is at quarterback. Empty backfield except for the running back. And Corey Johnson, man on the mark, puts down his guy, Marlon Bordenave. But it'll be second down and long.
From the 20-yard line, second down and 15. 13:35 and ticking in the opening quarter. 6-0 is our score. The Blackhawks on top of visiting Eagles.
So field position will be a problem for the Eagles. They went through three quarterbacks trying to figure out a decent system in the last matchup versus the Blackhawks. So we'll see if McKinney is able to go wire to wire. McKinney gets flushed out and in trouble. Bell is on him and almost picked off, I think.
It is
no whistle. That's Donye Coleman, 15-10, 5 touchdown. Still no whistle. And no decision still.
That'll make the score 12-0 after the touchdown on the interception with 12:53 to play in the opening quarter. They're going for two.
Yeah, there was no whistles, and ultimately the side judge on the near side ruled it a score, and the referee, Tom Isaacs, agreed. Handoff and a loose ball. Tony Parham tries to go up the middle, but he is thwarted. A swarm of Eagles there to thwart the two-point conversion try. It's 12-0 with 12:53 left in the first.
So 12-0 is our score. 12:53 to play in the opening quarter. With the Blackhawks on top. Here's the kickoff.
Mike Johnson, look at this one. He is greatly improved from the opening game of the year. Gage with the return from his 7. He'll get 10 yards to the 17-yard line going up the middle. Decent return. Seconds by now.
So 12:46 to play in the opening quarter. 12-6 is our, or 12-0 is our score with the Blackhawks, the host team, on top. Here come the Eagles setting up shop here at about the 19.
On the snap, handoff right side. It is a sweep. He uses his blocking, but it's not good enough as Roy Otis is there for the tackle. Should be stopped at the line of scrimmage or gain of one. Loss of
second down and 12 facing the Eagles with 12:23 and ticking in the opening quarter. 12-0 is our score. Blackhawks on top. Where's the ball? 18-yard line?
18-yard line works for us. Maybe just past the 17. One thing I did not want to ask the players today, because we know it's going to be a positive result for the Blackhawks, is it important to read your keys? It is, but probably not in a matchup like this. Maybe in 2 weeks. Oh, we have a loose
ball. Loose.
Bell's on it. And Coleman is there for the sack. Back. They're going to give him a little more credit than he deserved. Back at the 4. Maybe,
so,
maybe Vancouver Island.
Third and forever. Back from the 4-yard line.
Loose ball again.
Ball's loose.
It should be a safety. It is.
That's a safety.
As McKinney is dropped in the end zone, he bobbled the snap. It's an extra 2 for Inglewood. It's 14-0. 4 minutes into the game.
All right, 11:01 to play in the opening quarter. It is 14-0 after the safety recovered by the Blackhawks in the end zone.
We have a fun fact for you. If a free kick like we have here goes out of bounds, Blackhawks would have it first and 10 at the 50. How about that? That was an obscure rule I never knew until about 3 weeks ago. Terrell Lewis, who returned the first kickoff, brings it up 30, 40, and a nice shoulder check gets him out at the 43.
From the 45-yard line with 10:24 and ticking in the opening quarter, the Blackhawks will have the ball. They lead 14-0 against the visiting Eagles.
Solomon Jones and Tony Parham are flanked to the right. Jeremy Ruel is on the near side. First and 10, fakes the handoff, play action. Solomon Jones is deep and batted away.
Second and 10 from the 45-yard line with 9:59 and ticking in the opening quarter. 14-0 is our score. Blackhawks on top of the Eagles.
6 years ago today, the Eagles played the Foothill Firehawks and only achieved one first down. It's a fun fact from 6 years ago today. Hand off Gordon again. He carves up the middle. 40. 30.
Wow.
He eludes tacklers. 20.
Jeez.
And he's finally knocked down at the 14-yard line. That is a big gainer of 30 yards.
And for the Blackhawks down to the 15-yard line with 9 minutes to play in the opening quarter.
40-yard carry there. And there was either some movement or a timeout.
Let's do that again. They're at the just inside the 15, and there's 8:58 to play in the opening quarter. Leading 14-0, the Blackhawks are going to try to add to that lead against the Eagles. Kyle Parrish in the shotgun.
Chapman to his left, free play to the end zone, touchdown. It's Solomon Jones once again, who set a national record 2010 for touchdown receptions. He gets a score, should be a free play, and a touchdown for Inglewood.
With another touchdown, that'll make it 20-0 with 8:51 to play in the opening quarter. 14-yard pass, and here is the two-point try.
Under center for once in a low crouch. Tony Parham is flung back at the 10, a loss of 8, try for 2, no good.
Here's our kickoff with 8:51 to go in the opening quarter. Now it's 20-0. Blackhawks on top of the visiting Eagles.
Return is from the 15-yard line. Good speed up the middle. And it's returned up to the 39-yard line.
Here we go, 8:44 to go in this opening quarter. The Eagles coming out. They're trailing by 20 points from the 39-yard line.
Jamar Thornton made the tackle on kickoff return coverage. We have a flag before the snap.
So here we go. Picks up the flags. 39-yard line for the Eagles, trailing 20-0.
Oh, they're crashing in. Corner blitz. Bell is on him. And it's a drop and a loss of 9 back at the 30.
Second down. Facing the Eagles, they're backed up to, what is that, the 34, 33, 34-yard line. 7:50 and ticking in this second quarter, trailing 20-0, the host Blackhawks on top.
Well, we always say if you can't be left, be right. Second down. And Gage is at quarterback now. Oh, no.
Wow. Great escape.
He has room. 20, 30, 35,
are you kidding?
40, 45. He jukes one. He gets a first down. Unbelievable.
Wow,
what a run for Devin Gage.
That is an athlete right there.
Oh no! There's a flag.
Well, it all comes back after a block in the back. So 36-yard line, second and 12 facing the Eagles, trailing by 20 points.
Hand off. They go nowhere. Bell is having a heck of a game to start.
Third and long now. They're backed up to the 34-yard line. Eagles facing a 20-0 deficit.
Eric Ojeda is the wide receiver on the near side. Trips left, third forever. Bell almost deflected it. Pass complete, but thrown back. Big tackle for Brandon Smith out of Central Oklahoma. Fourth and long.
5:47 to play in this opening quarter. 20-0 is our score. Eagles are trailing. Fourth and 22 from the 28. Pretty sure they're going to punt it here.
What is the back judge? Oh boy, never mind.
All right.
Fourth down. And quick kick here. Oh, it's blocked off his butt. Are you kidding me? That's Bell. Have yourself a quarter, Dion Bell. We just had our own version of a butt fumble.
A butt block.
Oh my God.
Blackhawks take over after the blocked punt, the butt block of the punt. Where's the ball? They're going to mark it at the, what is that, the 8?
They're about, just on the 10. They're right
the
10, on the
10. Okay.
I really did not want to laugh at that remark, but my gosh, at this point, I'll find humor in some things, I guess.
That's right.
On first and goal, it's Brian Flowers, his patented move, bouncing to the left. Ooh, that's a big hit at the goal line.
Is he in? No.
No, he's at the 1.
So it looks like it's going to be second and goal at the 1 yard line with 5:34 to go in this opening quarter. 20-0, the Blackhawks are on top. They're trying to add to it.
And they're in the spread. How about that?
Here goes second and goal.
In a short field, no less. And off is Flowers, this time to the right. No, he lost a yard. How about that? Now the tackles are coming. See if they can do that in the middle of the field, second and goal.
Third down and goal. A victory if they can stop him on third down. I don't think it's going to happen, but here come the Blackhawks. They're going to throw into the end zone.
And that's a touchdown. That's a good touchdown. Catch for Deshaun Edmond. Blackhawks on top 26-0, and they are on fire right now.
So the Blackhawks leading 26-0, 4:53 to play in this opening quarter. They're going to go for two, and we'll come back from this timeout.
Going for two. Oh, the middle, got it. And Harry DeBerry lays it up and in.
Blackhawks, they got the conversion, so it's 28-0, right? 28-0,
yes.
With 4:53 to play in this opening quarter. Eagles are on their backs here.
Cool. And Mike Johnson went from a 30-yard kickoff man to a 50. Well, no, I'm serious. We've had kicker by committee. Deshaun Edmonds kicked off also, but he's turned into a 50-yard kicker. Look
nice.
At this one. Yeah, great improvement.
Bigfoot on that.
Yeah. Return from the 8. Tripped up. Big tackle by Gordon.
Trailing 28-0, the Eagles come out. Ball marked at the 29-yard line. Trailing 28-0, 4:44 to play in the opening quarter.
First and 10, Gage throws.
What
was that? That's not a flag, that was something pink. Remember the NFL one with pink flags? It confused everybody a few years ago.
So, penalty on the previous play?
I have no idea.
So the ball will be at the 33-yard line, first and 5, with 4:35 to play.
Okay, so that was a penalty marker. That really confused NFL players, and that's why it threw me for a loop. Gage to throw. He had a man to his left. Now he looks to his right. Flung back. Marcus Kelly threw him down like a rag doll.
He does not have any time. Ball back to the about the 24-yard line. Second and 15. Big loss on that previous play. 3:44 and ticking. Trailing 28-0. The Eagles come out of the huddle.
But Jay, you called it earlier, there is absolutely no time to develop a play because you look at the comparison of the lines, there's no match. June Harris, the rookie, there may be a fumble too.
There was a fumble on the previous play, recovered by the Blackhawks at the 20-yard line with 3:18 to play. They lead 28-0 over the Eagles. They're going to add to it here.
No playoff a joke, Mr. Black said over the PA system just earlier. Hey, June, it's October. June Harris started the fumble. Blackhawks recovered. And on a throw, bobbled. And really, the timing was thwarted when Kyle Parrish had difficulty. Ooh, we have a scuffle here.
Let's lose. Cool it, guys. Let's hope cooler heads prevail here. Sorting out the dirty laundry, it looks like they had a penalty against the Blackhawks, personal foul. That'll back them up with 3:13 to play in the opening quarter, leading 28-0. Where are they going to mark it? The 34?
I honestly thought the whatever item was thrown earlier was indeed dirty laundry. It is a pink flag, in fact.
Second and forever. Second and 20-something, 23 on the 34.
Well, it's only the first personal foul call in the game, so we call that progress. Second down.
Met in the backfield. Wow.
Yeah, there we go.
Third down from the 32 with 2:37 and ticking in this opening quarter. 28-0 Blackhawks on top. They're looking for more blood.
Yeah. Not enough for the Red Cross to handle. It's Kyle Parrish.
Parrish.
Ooh, that, I thought that was a block in the back, but as it is. Big play on the tackle there. Victor Ofo with the sack.
All right, so we're looking at, is it third down again? So we had a penalty.
And it's marked off 5 yards for neutral zone infraction by the Eagles. Declined, fourth down now.
I think it's third again.
Yeah, I thought it was third too. Kyle Parrish will go for it all. It's a wobbler though to Sullivan Jones. Out at the four. Yes, first and goal.
What a pretty pitch and catch that one.
Yeah.
Blackhawks were hurry up for a first and goal with 1:51 and ticking in the opening quarter, leading 28-0. Where are they marked? Five?
4 yard line, four just yard inside line. The four. Great tippy toe catch. Chapman. Right, left, touchdown. Just like you would on your joystick playing Madden.
Exactly.
My goodness.
So they're going for two. It's 34-0 with 1:32 to play in the opening quarter.
This looks busted over the middle, swatted by an offensive lineman. The ball is loose, and it is no good.
34-0 will be our score. 34-0 with 1:32 to play in the opening quarter.
Yeah, you really made that sound exciting.
Oh my gosh.
With conviction. You may have a job in the business, who knows? He turned this from the 40 and it's a loose ball. And the Eagles will cover it up at the 41-yard line. So 113. Yeah, like 2 years ago.
40-yard line, Eagles trailing by 34.
Oh, come on, Jay, you're not excited for this play? What's going on? I think it was 2 years ago.
All right, 40-yard line, 1:28 to go in the opening quarter. 34-0 is our score. The Blackhawks on top. Eagles trying to get on the board desperately.
Mm. Gage first down throws. Picked off, Donnie Coleman again.
That was an athletic move right there.
Very, he leapt up high. It will be a 42-yard return for touchdown.
This is turning into a video game right here.
Easily.
40, Eagles 0, 1:15 to play in the opening quarter. They're going to just be able to choose their own score.
Sure. Sure the bookies did too. Handoff reverse. It's Parham off the handoff from Flowers. It's Ruel, rather.
He got it.
With
he
the
got
flag.
It. And we got dirty laundry. So they're going to try it again. The only thing they haven't been able to do is convert all their 2 points. They're backed up by a penalty to the 12-yard line with 1:15 to play. They score 40-0. Blackhawks on top.
Now the Eagles accepted the penalty so that the 2 points does not get charged against them. So we'll go for two again.
Oh, that's something he's bumping, but he's telling on himself. Uh-oh, they're taking that.
Different this time, loose ball.
Oh, boy.
Comedy of errors. Try for two, no good. So it worked.
That's right. Long story short, no good.
Yeah. Off return from the 37-yard line.
Uh-oh,
and up to the 42.
So here, oh, go ahead.
I'm sorry.
Can you got a witness here? You definitely got a witness.
First and 10 from the 42-yard line. Blackhawks on top by a bunch. This was off the board in Vegas in March. Almost picked up by Roy Otis. Would have been the third.
Oh, 43-yard line. 24 seconds left in the quarter. Eagles come up to the line. They trail 40-0.
Not a misprint. And we did not stutter. Final play of the first quarter. Deion Bell hot on Gage. Ooh, Bell still on him within contact. Throw complete.
Wow.
And a first down. How about that? He gets the Dante Johnson for a 12-yard completion that was doomed from the start.
So, start the second quarter. 40-0 is our score.
Gage the throw. How about that play to end the first quarter? Gage.
Ooh.
A deep ball. Incomplete. Deflected by Curtis Perkins.
Aggressive. Going downfield.
I love it.
14:43 to play in the half. And they are at the 42-yard line. Second down and 10. I like the tactic. Why not? Why not go deep? Test the waters.
Yeah, nothing to lose. I mean, see how the secondary works, because it has not been tested at all. Yeah. 42 going in, positive field position. And this time it's trips right. They did four to the left earlier. Pretty uncommon. Four-man front, they're crashing in. Throw, incomplete, nearly picked up by Coleman.
Third down facing the visiting Eagles. They trail 40-0 with 13:34 and ticking in this second quarter.
Double wide either side. They need the 32 to continue the drive. Gage. Ooh! Flores just got his helmet flung off. It lost 5 yards. And the Eagles, as a team, gain 5 themselves.
So, Eagles. Penalty, I guess, on the previous play. So, third and forever, backed up to the 47.
And you're correct with that. It was holding on the play. Third down. Coleman playing zone. Pass. Nice. Complete to a fullback. Hey, congrats. Opening up the playbook finally. Here gets 5 yards. It'll be fourth and about 15.
Too little, too late, but nice idea.
I love it.
Here we go, Eagles. Fourth down and 20 forever.
There. No, it's a fake.
He's got to have forever to go.
And they're going to let him do whatever they want. Big block on Johnson. Gage to... All right. Cut block. Nothing called.
Good night.
Wow, that is a loss of 20 yards.
Oh, looks like we got some extracurricular activity. Let's calm down, fellows.
There was not one, but maybe two illegal blocks on Mike Johnson. He's down in a heap. And the... About 80% of the Blackhawk roster is on the field.
Yeah, we don't need that. Cooler heads should prevail, hopefully, here.
Completely uncalled for. Tony outed out a player. He just pointed at someone. I mean, if you're going to hit someone, do it right. We all work the next day. Well, I know it's Sunday, but... We all want to be healthy and move on with our regular lives without taking a cheap shot like what happened.
Looks like we're going to be good. So after the turnover on downs and extracurricular activity, we've got the ball at the 31-yard line. The Blackhawks have a big lead, 40-0, with 12:15 to play in the opening half against this Eagle team visiting.
And they're still discussing.
Blackhawks will come out with the four wide receiver set, five wide receiver set, three to the left, one to the right with a tight end, Parrish in the shotgun.
Parrish looking over the middle, Solly off his shoulder, picked off at the goal line. First down, Eagles.
So after the pick, 1 yard line, Eagles will take over. With 12:03 to play in the half, they trail big, 40-0.
Well, I was a defensive coordinator for one play, and I said, bring all 11. They scored from 99, and I retired after a DC for just one play. They're not gonna bring 10 here. It's flag football, so it doesn't count. First and 10 from the one. And Ely almost had a pick.
Yeah, Al Davis wanted it.
Yeah.
This is the Eagles facing second down and 10 from the one. 11:48 to play in the first half, trailing 40-0. in the eye, Gage throws, complete. And a 3-yard completion up to the 4. Fair enough.
The 5-yard line, so that'll be 3rd and about 4. Or 3rd and 6, rather.
The yard line to make is the 11.
I got my copy.
It is makeable. They've gone deep before to test the waters of the deep secondary. In a zone, they flash back. Gage against the grain. He'll throw, almost picked up by Johnson, and it is dropped
in and out of the hands. Fourth down, facing the Eagles on the 5-yard line.
Oh gosh, and they are going. No, they can't be going for it.
Wow. So 10, 15, and tick, tick, ticking. They're letting this clock lead. Appears they want to go for it. 6 yards.
Well, this game is a slow lose. There it is. Quick kick. No, he's going to throw. Oh, good Lord. Gage will throw. Complete. See how this goes. They get another first down.
They did get the first
down. Man, he was on his end line.
Believe it or not, the Eagles have just moved the chains. From the 14-yard line, they've got first and 10, 13-yard line, with 9:40 and ticking in this first half. They trail 40-0. They're on the wrong end of this one. But they're going down the field.
They did a busted play every snap. They'd get somewhere. Because that's what's worked, the busted play. Gage throws. Nice catch. 15-yard line, gain of about 2.
Line up, second down. They're at the, where are they marked now?
17 now.
Yard line. 8:31 to play in the first half, trailing 40-0. He's got time to throw.
And it's over the hand and intended. Lewis almost had the pick, but it sailed over his helmet.
From the 17, third down. And about 8, facing the Eagles with 8:13 and ticking in this opening half, and they trail by a lot.
Well, soon enough, the second stringers are going to get some shine, but right now, you look on the field, as far as the defense, you have Allen, you have Kelly, you have B.J. Johnson, you have Otis, you have Mike Johnson, you have Corey Johnson, you have Michael Gilliam, you have Lewis, can't see who's on the far side, you have Ely in the secondary, and a flag.
Penalty on the play, third down, and now go to about 13 to get that first down. They're backed up to the 11 with 7:35 and ticking in this first down.
Well, the 11th one we mentioned, we want to mention is Harris. So the first unit is still there for the Blackhawks. Gage to throw. Blitz is picked up, pass complete. They get another first down, and that's the second first down in this series. This is a problem. The Blackhawks have not scored in 8 minutes of game time. This is an issue. It must be addressed. First down, and it almost got remedied.
Almost answered that. Eagles face second down and 10 from the 28th. They mark it 6:25, and they're letting this clock bleed. Trailing 40-0, the Eagles. Well, they've got a couple first downs here. Let's see if they can put something together on this drive.
So you're saying these are transfusions? Okay, I'm done. I should. Here's Kelly. He's on Gage. Yeah, nice ball.
Wow, he came down with it.
That was a slick throw.
They're in Blackhawk territory, ladies and gentlemen.
It's Lee Fultz with the catch.
So now they're at the 46-yard line of the Blackhawks. Can you believe they're in Inglewood territory with 5:33 and ticking to go? They're trailing by 40 points, but somebody told them the game is not over, so they're playing.
No, I agree. No, great point, Jay, because, I mean, you know, it's 40-0. Most people say, gosh, you know, just burn the tape. But, you know, it's amazing that they are successful on busted plays.
Uh-oh,
this one isn't. Lewis, no way.
In and out.
Should have had it.
Eagles face second down and 10 from the 46. 4:55. Tick, 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 tick. In this half. Taking their time. Might want to get a snap off before a penalty.
Yeah, they won't. We'll see. Empty backfield.
There we go.
Prevent defense be damned. Second and 10. Screen, which turns out to be a deep ball, no good.
46-yard line. Third down and 10, facing the Eagles with 4:16 to go, and tick, tick, tick in this first
down. And it's going up against the Blackhawks' first unit still. No one, they have not made any changes.
All the ones are in.
Yep. The Black caught this earlier, it was on the left side, but here they are, four wide receivers this side.
And one to the left.
Okay. Explain the science. Come on, Bill Nye, help us out. Gage. Another busted play.
You got to give Gage some credit with his feet right here. Look at that.
Oh, what a move! He's out the...
First the ball at the 30 and flag. Will be against the Blackhawks, so first down for the Eagles. You know, they started at their own 1 yard line.
That's crazy. We have a great statistician to our left, and he was very helpful with this. They're motoring.
They're motoring. From the 33.
Gage. There you go again. We'll just let you see the pictures.
This kid can play a little bit of football right here. Look at him go.
They need it's a loose ball though. And Gilliam picks it up.
So there was a fumble at the end of that play, recovered by the Blackhawks. So that was the bright spot for the Eagles. It ends on a turnover. Blackhawks will have the ball at the 18. They lead 40-0 with 3 minutes to go in this.
Timeout somebody.
Come out after the timeout. First and 10 from the 18, leading 40-0 after the fumble.
Eagles just burned their third and final timeout. He bobbles the ball and will have to take it himself, but Kyle can run. He gets five, he gets about six, and nearly gets hit late out of bounds.
Second and 4, ball marked at the 24-yard line, 2:50 to play in the half. 40-0, the host Blackhawks on top of the visiting Eagles.
And it's surprising, no scoring in this quarter.
That might change pretty quick.
Parrish to throw, he's thrown for 2,500 in the regular year. And this one was nearly intercepted in the middle.
Here we go, Blackhawks, 3rd and 4 from the 24 with 2:13 to go in the half.
Final play before the 2 minute warning. Handoff goes to the left off of left guard. Gain of about 4 near the first down marker.
Blackhawks do move the chains. Do they? Yeah, they do, right? First down?
Oh,
yeah.
They did get enough.
Yeah.
After the measurement. In the 2 minute timeout.
It's the 2 minute warning, so 40-0.
92, did they lose his weight?
In the 27 yard line. First and 10, Kyle Parrish.
Parrish.
Oh!
Carter almost made the catch and it's incomplete and on the near side. What was it for?
Still sorting out the penalty. Back up the Blackhawks, penalty. Now backed up to the, 18?
About the 18-yard line. Yeah. Minute 55 left in the half. Parrish to throw. This time picked off. Jay Pryor with the intercept. Flag on the play, dropped at the 10. We'll see who the marker is on.
44. After the turnover, the Eagles will have really good field position. First and 10 with 1:42 to play in the opening half. They trail 40-0, but they're still playing.
So the penalty after the change of possession did not help the Eagles. Of course, I'm sure cooler heads are not prevailing, and that's what happened on that play. So Gage brings the troops up to the line. 1:42 left until halftime. 43-yard line going in. Now at this point, you do want the opposition to score.
He's going deep.
Gage picked off.
That is an Inglewood ball.
That is.
We'll take it after the interception. 5-yard line with 1:32 to play. They lead 40-0.
Can they get a 95-yarder? Parrish handoff. He eludes one, gets across the 10 to the 11-yard line. Clock running. No huddle offense. 1:15 to go in the half.
Kyle wants it.
Parrish. Oh, this is dangerous, boy. Yeah. He cringed there. Yeah.
First down for the Blackhawks. 52 seconds and ticking.
Parrish will throw. DeBerry, no good.
Second down facing the Blackhawks. 46 ticks left in the half. They lead 40-0. Ball at about the 18-yard line.
Parrish to throw. Great protection. Complete. And out of bounds. Stops the clock.
39.5 ticks.
DeBerry with the catch. Less than 40 seconds to go in the half. Parrish to throw. Good protection again. Swings it out. Chapman, 35. Forced out at the 39. Stops the clock with 33 seconds remaining.
Keep the camera rolling here. With
the timeout situation, the Eagles are out of timeouts. The Blackhawks, let's see, have two left. They burned one midway through the first quarter. Second down from the 39. Blackhawks operating. We'll see if they have enough personnel. That's a problem. No one blocking. Parrish has all day. Going for it deep for Carter. He's pushed out of bounds, though. Incomplete.
Third down facing the Blackhawks. 25.5 seconds left in this half. Leading 40-0.
Yeah, but who's counting? I mean the seconds. Okay, not the score. Parrish to throw.
From the 40.
Out of time. Goes for it. Solomon Jones. In the hands at the 31, he's gone. It will be a 67-yard touchdown.
Covered engines, we have no idea here.
46-0. They're going to go for two, trying to make it 48 with 14 seconds left to play in the half.
Parrish has Flowers to his right, Chapman to his left. The give is, no, it's not the Flowers. Parrish, he does have a man. Oh, incomplete, almost caught. So by Tyrone Leakins.
Blackhawks up big, 46-0 with 14 ticks left in this half. They're going to kick it off to the Eagles. Maybe the Eagles can get a big return here and something will happen.
Oh, here we go, Squibb. Return from the 40, runs the clock, 12 seconds. Oh! Couple bowling balls there.
Here come the Eagles. 9 ticks left in the half.
They're going to a knee. That's the best thing they have done all night. It is halftime. When we return, your third quarter score will be Blackhawks 46 and the Eagles nothing.
We're going to start the third quarter. It's 46-0. And the Eagles are going to receive this one.
My mind works on overdrive. You know, one of the things we were thinking about, talking about working on overdrive is Devin Gage. What video game is he playing? Because clearly he must have Google Glass on and he's got Madden in his view.
Yeah, he's got 99 speed on Madden, that's for sure.
Everything. 35-yard line on the return, dropped at the 42. Ooh, almost a fumble, but ruled Eagle ball.
Eagles ball. 41-yard line, 14:52 in this third quarter. Let's hope this clock leads quick. 46-point edge. Yeah. And whistles.
Oh, come on.
We will be underway here after a brief delay.
Oh, here we go. That's nice. Here's Gage.
The option. Wow.
We are completely against the option, but that got 5.
It did get 5, Nebraska. They actually gained 5 on that play. Second and 5, 14 minutes and 8 seconds to go. Third.
This game has gone up in smoke, hasn't it? Second down. Gage with time. And he's staying in the pocket.
Too high.
Nearly intercepted by Thornton.
13:26 to go in the third quarter. 46-0. Eagles are on the wrong side of that number against the host Blackhawks. They're still fighting.
It is a warm night. 82 at this point, but there has not been any wind at all this evening. Gage
couldn't get out of that.
No, not at all.
So the 5 yards they gained, they just gave up. So it's fourth down and about 11 from the 40-yard line. Looks like they want to go for it. They trail by 46. Why not? From the...
worthy gamble.
Oh, no, they're going to punt it.
They're going to kick out of this.
They did punt.
Jones. Uh-oh. Could have let it go for a touchback.
Jones is up.
He'll get the 20 anyway.
And two more for good measure.
Sure.
24-yard line. Blackhawks will come out on offense. This is not a nail biter. It's a 46-point game.
It's to the nub. Take the draw.
5-yard advance on the penalty. First and five. Ball 29-yard line. 12 minutes to play in the third quarter. 46-0.
Illegal participation was the call. Gordon.
Nice cutback.
Devin Gage move. He took notes. 45. Midfield.
Huddle. And from the 49-yard line. First and down. And timeout. So, first and 10 up to the 49. They move the chains. Inglewood, 46-0 with 11:25 to go in the third quarter.
Eagles just burned a timeout, so they're down to two. Blackhawks have all three. They'll probably burn them all still in this blowout. Pretty remarkable. Near midfield, first and 10, trips right. Parrish. He gets Jeremy Ruel. And he's flung around.
I thought he was going to lateral for a second.
Me too.
No huddle.
Boy, they really jobbed Ruel. Pushed back.
All right, so they resume play.
Well, they screwed Ruel out of two extra yards. Pass incomplete. Should be at the 45. The greatest play in the history of Western civilization.
Oh, my God.
I love him.
We're talking about Bill Walton. This is the 48-yard line, the Blackhawks. They face third and about five, right? They're in maybe six?
Yeah.
With 10:36 to play in the third quarter. They're up 46-0.
Should be third and four, but I'm over it. And there are allegedly fireworks going on. Pass.
Nice catch.
Carter. EA Sports out of bounds at the 30.
Moving the chains. 29-yard line. Blackhawks up 46-0. First and 10. 10 minutes to play in the third.
They get 22 in the previous play. Parrish. Looking for a safety foul.
He got it.
He gets Jones.
Still no.
Oh, a couple joystick moves. 20, 15, and a loose ball. Couldn't tell who had it.
A little too much there, huh?
10, 19-yard line. They're moving upfield. Blackhawks recover the fumble. Draw play, Gordon. Gordon gets room, gets time, gets to the 10. He gets 9. Quarter time.
Tick, 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 tick.
Edgar Rosales snaps it to Jeremy, to Kyle Parrish, and he was looking for Jeremy Ruel. Incomplete.
At 8:38 and ticking in the third quarter. 46-0 is our score. Inglewood is on top of the visiting Eagles.
Third and two.
That's the 11.
Makeable first down here.
He's keeping it.
Parrish. He averages a carry for a touchdown per game. Down to the two, first and goal.
No huddle for the Blackhawks. 8:05 and taking the third. Up 46-0.
Parrish. Well, no. He'll take it himself.
He's got the corner. That's six.
Wow. And for the fifth straight game, he has a rushing touchdown.
Nicely done, Kyle. Actually going to try to kick an extra point here.
Oh my God.
NFL rules, they got to back it up. So,
that's Donye Coleman. Oh my gosh.
It's 52-0 at the moment. They're going to try to add a point.
Instagram special.
Instagram special. Extra points are backed up this year, NFL rules.
It's on Bill Belichick's snap face.
And that's not going to happen.
Low and to the right.
52-0 will remain the score with 7:53 to go in third. Inglewood Blackhawks up 52-0 in this contest with 7:53 to go in the third quarter. Eagles showed some life late in the second half, but or first half, I should say, but
they still had what amounted to about, I want to say roughly around a 65-yard drive.
Yeah, from the 1-yard line.
And they made most of those plays. They weren't due to careless mistakes by Inglewood, so full credit to the Eagles. Kickoff return from the 15.
Ooh, he's going to get hit out of... No, he's still in bounds.
The running back gets to the 25. Yeah, I agree.
I just yawned. That's the 25-yard line. The Eagles will start. 7:43 to go in the third quarter. 52-0.
Oh, we were live? That's unfortunate.
scintillating action here.
First and 10. Gage. Ooh, Sewell drops him. Billy Sewell had a monster game in the first quarter. In my roundup, I missed this, I missed that.
Right.
You're right, I probably did, but I try and get the most important highlights to get in for the people to
right.
read.
It's an art. Eagles will have the ball, 6:38 and ticking, 52-0. They trail back up their own 16.
And new quarterback this time, McKinney. And boy, he is in the middle of an Eagle of a Blackhawks sandwich.
New quarterback, same result.
Yeah.
Eagles are going the wrong way. Second down, or third down, and forever. Backed up to the 10-yard line. 5:51 to play. They're trailing big time, 52-0. Blackhawks all over this Eagles team.
They snap it with two. Gage back in. Wow,
nice arm.
Thornton almost had a pick. Two.
Eagles.
3 seconds to snap.
Oh,
we
no, it's
liftoff.
Over his head.
Uh-oh.
That's going to be 2 points.
DJ Mike Johnson gets the safety. It'll be 54-0.
54-0.
In the third.
Yeah. Eagles will kick it away, punt it away after the safety. 54-0. Inglewood on top. 5 minutes and 9 ticks to go. Awaiting the whistle. There it goes.
And the free kick from the 20. Returned by J.R. White. Oh no! And how about this? The Blackhawks pick it up. That is loose.
This might be ugly for the Eagles.
Oh, big block!
He got the corner, and he is going to score.
Lincoln's will go in for the score, but there are two flags on the field.
We've got dirty laundry over here. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my God.
40-yard line, Inglewood. Touchdown's called back. Too many dirty laundry plays on the...
First and 10, up the middle. Nice Chapman running to the... SoCal 47-yard line, first down, 13 yards on the carry. Using credit to the offensive line every time. And confusion.
They beat Oregon. Wow, here we go. First down for the Inglewood Blackhawks.
Clock runs, 4:25 left until three-quarter time. Second and five.
Second and five, sorry.
And Parrish on a rollout. What an arm! Wait, is that a catch? No good.
No catch.
It skidded off the turf. Team so much different now.
Third, is it second down or third?
Maybe third.
Well, they're calling it second on the far end.
I'm confused.
From
the
40.
We'll take a fifth down. Here's Chapman.
Are we in Colorado?
Well, yeah.
Nicely done.
This is field. 29-yard line.
First down.
And 12-yard carry.
All right, they're going to break the huddle.
That's such a great story.
You'll get it. With
3:11, this one.
3:11 to play in the third quarter. 54-0 is the score. Inglewood on top.
The down marker dude is way off track. This is a first down.
Yeah, it is. And their ball at the 30 or 29.
Down marker, first down! Unbelievable.
Uh-oh, here we go. We're going up top.
Parrish complete to B Flow at the 29. He'll get three out of it, out of the 26. No, that was. Oh.
It should be second down.
No, it's second down.
It should be second.
Second down!
35 to play in the third quarter. 54-0.
Down marker dude is not awake.
Oh, we're going up.
Pass is incomplete, intended for Flowers.
So now we got third down.
What? They moved it back to fourth.
It should
it's
be
only
third.
The third play after the 12-yard run play.
Went 55 to go in the third quarter. 54-0.
So once again, the Blackhawks are screwed out of a I hope I'm right. Kyle Parrish, he needs a 20. He gets the 15.
He got it.
No, he gets the 20.
Did he?
And he doesn't get the first down.
Yeah, we move the chain. Regardless, we have a first down. Quick game reset. 1:46 to play in the third quarter. 54-0.
Move the chains.
Blackhawks are on top. First and 10, moving the chains, and we've got a conference. It's clock's ticking, 1:36 and ticking. Third quarter, 54-0.
Looking to add Parrish. Everyone's on a go route to Parham at the 10. There's the old-fashioned curl. You don't see that much anymore. Down to the 5, first and goal with 1:20 to go.
No huddle. In fact, I was sitting with Parham in that press box when the Bears were playing the Stars before he became a Blackhawk.
In motion is Parham. And time. Parrish. I think he got it.
He was
out of bounds.
So that's when I found out that everybody was ripping my DVDs and putting them on YouTube.
Hey!
Yeah. At the goal line.
It's Chapman. And he's over the goal line.
That is a touchdown.
Touchdown, Inglewood.
42 seconds to go in the third. That'll make it 60-0.
And it's Chapman.
Here comes the extra point.
Go.
NFL rules.
Is this Johnson? Carter is holding. Uh-oh.
It's
Carter will pick it up. Carter has speed, though. He'll throw! No good, deflected, intended for Leakins. That was almost magical.
60-0 will be remain the score. All right, we've got some pushing and shoving. Let's cool down, fellows.
Utley took out Ruben Tejada. Nice.
Let's break it up, fellows. Looks like cooler heads will prevail here. So, looks like that injured player is cleared. He's going to be okay. 42 seconds left to go in the third quarter. It's 60-0. Blackhawks are on top of the visiting Eagles. They're going to kick it off.
Looks like it was Devin Gage that they're giving medical attention to.
Hope he's okay.
Over on the near side. Donye Coleman will put the ball in play. Oh, here we go. And they were offside, so it won't matter. And we'll probably re-kick 5 yards back.
They pick up the flags as the Eagles will take the ball at the 37-yard line. They're one of their better field position starts here of the game. 39 ticks left in the third quarter, trailing 60-0. They're still playing though.
If you enjoy math and you're keeping score, we have JT Squared in the booth today.
That's right.
Jay Tando, John Tyler, great to have you with us. Temperature has lowered from 80 to 79. Breaking news, first and 10. 39 seconds to go on a jump pass, complete. Corey Johnson, almost a horse collar, gets him at the shoulder.
Here is the ball at the 30, what is that, 31, 32? And whistle. So we begin the fourth quarter, 60-0. Inglewood is on defense.
Uh-oh. Oh boy.
And they are bringing
Marcus
the wood.
Kelly is there. Definitely. Oh, Edward Flores! Keep filming. There it is.
Well, we have it on tape.
All right.
So negate that last play. It was offside. So third down and short. Right?
Or worse. I have no idea anymore.
Yeah, I think they're going to give him a first down.
Never saw the flag call. I'm over it at this point.
They're still talking about it.
When it's 60-0 in the end, you really don't want to gripe about the small stuff.
Right. Either way, they're at the 25-yard line with 14 minutes to go here.
Oh,
ball's loose.
McKinney. Has trouble. And, almost too much trouble.
And they're going to actually stop the clock. What? Eagles, second down, ball at the 25-yard line. If they score here and get the 54-point conversion, we're tied.
Is this rockin' job?
From the 25, it's second down.
Okay, I know, that was a 90s reference, and some of you are 10 watching this and going, what is rockin' job? You missed out on the greatest exhibition of basketball in the history of Western civilization.
Shotgun.
YouTube it. Second and 10. And they'll throw.
It's tipped,
and
it's picked.
Kicked off.
Inglewood has the ball.
J.R. White. Damian Douglas deflected it, causing the fumble.
To the 40.
And there was a second one. But Inglewood picks it up at the 40.
Politically correct. So, four. We're still working on an Eagles player. Blackhawks will come out to the 40-yard line with 13:27 to play in the ball game. They're up 60-0 in this not so much a back and forth contest. All Inglewood today, tonight.
First and 10. And first down, Blackhawks into Eagle territory. Chapman.
Chapman's running the rock pretty well tonight.
Chapman with two scores, Coleman with two scores on the night.
44-yard line, first and 10 for the Inglewood Blackhawks, leading 60-0. You heard that right. 12:54 to play in the ballgame. They're going to keep it on the ground. Nice. Cuts it.
It's Gordon to the 20. He's trying to get his second score of the day. He does. Touchdown, Blackhawks.
66-0. 12:42 to play in the ball game. They're gonna line up here for two. And there's the
and
throw.
And the fade, Coleman throwing.
Not gonna happen.
Flags. Intended for Leakins.
Inglewood will try it again from the 1 yard line this time.
Pass interference charge to the defense. Coleman under center. Fakes a handoff, throws it. I think he caught it. He does for the 2-point conversion. Leakins.
68-0 with 12:42 to play in the ballgame. Leading 68-0, Inglewood will kick it off with 12:42 to play in the contest.
Well, we were going to play who's going to kick this time, but it looks like it will be Mike Johnson. Blackhawks will be at Saboba to take on the Coyotes on Sunday the 25th. Here we go. Ooh, right to him on the shoulder. Cut block, hit, down, 40-yard line.
Here we go.
12:30 to go.
Eagles will come up to the line. Yep, 12:30 to go. It is, what is it, first and 10. They're going to have the ball at the 45-yard line.
Jay, is that 54-point play still on the table?
Touchdown and a 62-point conversion.
Oh, okay. So they have to kick it from, what, Newhall or?
Yeah.
Blitz! Are you serious?
Wow.
Whoa.
They're not pulling any punches.
Incomplete.
Second down facing the visiting Eagles from the 45-yard line. 12:26 and ticking in the ball game.
Ever since the Blackhawks scored 40 after one quarter, it's been 28 for two quarters and change. They'll be okay with this win. Of course, they won't be satisfied. I mean, they still wanted to execute and it didn't happen here in the second half, but win is still a win. And 1-0. Intercepted, Corey Johnson. Ball down at the 47-yard line. Intercepted either.
Inglewood will take over after the turnover. 48-yard line. 11:32 to play.
You know, usually we see a pure meltdown in blowouts like this. It may start to emanate here because the look at this, a double wing formation.
Double wing formation.
and it's Flowers up the middle. So oh, no deception there. Up the gut. He's down inside the five. That's a 43-yard play.
Yeah. Now they got first and goal at the 4-yard line with 10:35 to play in the ballgame. 68-0 double, is the score.
And double wing again. See if they throw some deception to mess up the defensive front. They don't. Oh, he got pushed down by his own player. Uncalled for.
See if they huddle. Well, another thing I like about the double wing is now if they do see this, your opponents, they got to study for it and they got to prepare for it.
Yep.
So you throw out another wrinkle at him.
And double wing again. If they pull a reverse out of this, ooh, he almost stepped on offensive
lineman. He wants the corner.
Coleman gets his third score of the game, first on offense.
74 to Zippo. 74 points have been scored by Inglewood here, and we got a lot of football left.
Too much. Too much football left.
And they're going to go for two.
Going for two. Should run the clock on conversions. Coleman throws.
Jump pass. Tennessee
no, picked
style.
Off.
He's going the other way.
Coleman still does not going. Knock him down. Leakins does.
74-0. 9:42 to play. I cannot believe they're not running the clock out
and
on this.
Finally, a chill in the air.
Yeah, it's starting to cool off a bit.
It's 78.
35-yard line. They're going to kick it off. Eagles trying to muster something here. Let's see if they can scrape together some offense. Because the defense has not been over here tonight, ladies
Coleman
and gentlemen.
Will kick.
Oh. Boom, a little dribbler.
There you go. Uh-oh. And the
Eagles football.
Eagles get it at the 49.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, wait, Blackhawks have it.
They're oh, they gave it to the Blackhawks. Okay. So Blackhawks recover the onside. 48-yard line of the Eagles. They have the ball with 9:39 to play and a 74-point edge.
Edge?
And whistle, yeah.
Edge?
I know, they're just clinging to that razor-thin advantage. All right, Inglewood from the 48-yard line. First and 10, 9:38 to play in the game. What in the world could they be talking about? Breaking the huddle.
Russell Hamilton can only advise so much. All right, back to the line, Coleman at quarterback. It's to Parham on an old-fashioned sweep.
Fly sweep.
First plays you learn. 30. Ooh, wow. 28-yard line.
First down. Ball at the 27. 9:08 to play in the ball game. Inglewood up.
Down. Ooh, they crash in. Blitz. Gordon. Gordon trying for a hat trick. 10-yard line. Oh, what moves? 5-yard line to the 2. And a flag.
Got some dirty laundry. So we had some flags on the play, some holding. So first down, but it's going to be at the, where is it? 19. And another whistle.
Oh my God, it is.
So first down from the 17-yard line.
After the holding call from the 19. Coleman in trouble. He'll move.
He's
throw
on the run.
Picked off at the 7-yard line.
Intercepted. So the Eagles will have the ball after the interception at the 7-yard line with 7:44 to play in the contest. They are trailing by 74 points. Inglewood has just gone up and down all day.
Two safeties in the game, two pick sixes.
All Inglewood.
Coming in on a full house blitz. Pass. Deflected. Picked off. Touchdown.
That is ridiculous
right there. Wow. What a play. Orlando Bryant with the pick and score.
We got 80 points. So here comes a two-point try from Inglewood to try to make it an 82-point game.
What was the over-under on this? Okay, I'll stop.
Oh, boy.
Double wing. That is Chapman. Chapman is in for two.
That's 2 points. 82-0 with 6:11 to go.
State won it in double overtime.
Holy smoke.
Oregon Ducks fall. Was it at Wazoo? It must have been.
Yeah.
Inglewood will kick off from the 35. There's 4:50. It's ticking, thank God.
Oh, well, yeah.
With an 82-point lead, you should bleed the clock. And they are bleeding the clock. They've come to their senses. As this fourth quarter is going to be over mercifully soon. 4:39. Tick, 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 tick. Who is this kicker?
Donya Coleman now, as he did earlier. Squib, picked up. Return, 40-yard line. Loose ball though. I think the Blackhawks got it.
This is really bad. Another turnover. Blackhawks football. Well, the Blackhawks do get the ball back after the fumble on the kickoff return. 37-yard line, first and 10, 3:36 and ticking in the fourth quarter. 82-0 is our score.
Double wing again. And off, Chapman breaks it free. 40-yard line, tripped up. No, still going. 35, 32-yard line, first down. I don't even want to ride a roundup.
Your hands will, you know, your fingers will fall asleep.
I'll have carpal tunnel.
That's what I was looking for. And here come the Blackhawks. Did they call timeout?
They did.
Blackhawks up to the line of scrimmage after we have a fallen Eagle player. He's getting up. He's going to be okay. 2:51. And they did stop the clock on that. 2:53. And ticking. 82 points the Inglewood has put up on this Eagle team. And
Chapman to the left of Coleman. Coleman to throw. He does have an arm, incomplete, intended for Leakins. 2 minute warning has been given to both benches, and they should decline the 2 minute warning.
It's 2 minute warning.
Clock runs to 2 minutes to go, 2nd and 13. Ruel short side, double wide to the right. And they're bringing six. Coleman to throw. Coleman with a lot of time. 30, 25, first down at the 18. And he almost got flung around like a pretzel.
No huddle for the Blackhawks with 1:26 to play in the ball game, leading 82-0. First down, moves the chains at the 19.
First and 10, 20-yard line. Split formation, only one safety back. Coleman will throw. He gets his man. It's a first down.
Keep it rolling as the Blackhawks.
1 minute left in the game. They want 90.
They're marking it inside the 10. 9-yard line.
Leakins caught the previous pass. Coleman still at quarterback. Chapman to his left. Leakins is open. No good. Ooh, he got hit hard. Good, he gets up.
24 ticks left in the ball game with an 82-0 score. Inglewood lines up from the 9-yard line, second down and goal.
And they'll get this snap off. That was
stop the clock.
Spike,
7.6
yeah.
Ticks left. And 3, 2.
That will do it.
That'll do it. Ball game's over. 82-0 is our final.
No wrap up.
All right. I've been Jay Tando. I've been filming, and John Tyler's been our play-by-play guy. Thanks for listening and watching. 82-0 is our final score here in Inglewood as the Blackhawks blow out the visiting Eagles.
Do want to remind you before Jay cuts out that the big game is on October 25th at the Sebobo Reservation. Beautiful field. What a setting for not only the contest, but what a beautiful venue it'll be when the Coyotes play host to the Blackhawks high noon 2 weeks from tomorrow. Join us then. Thanks for watching. For all of us here at Blackhawk TV, have yourself a pleasant good night.
Thank you, John Tyler.
No problem. Thank you. Thank you.